Welcome back, and joining us now to answer your pet questions, Dr. Karen Birx in for Dr. Kim Hammond this morning. And our little guest is here for a very special reason.
This is Gizmo.
Gizmo.
Okay. He's a four-year-old Chorky, a Chihuahua Yorkie mix. He's a member of the Eckert family.
Mm-hmm. And Gizmo gets into trouble.
He does. On a couple of occasions, he has. He's actually gotten into sugar-free gum containing xylitol.
Now, this isn't all sugar-free gums.
Correct. It's just the ones that contain xylitol. But xylitol basically binds with sugar in the blood and, competes with sugar in the blood mm-hmm. and causes low blood sugar, significantly low enough that it can cause seizures and death. And at high enough doses, it can actually cause liver failure and death from it.
And this happens quickly.
It does. It usually does. Usually within 1 to 6 hours. At higher doses, you can see liver failure up to 3 days later. So
if you have any of this around the house, it's like keep it away.
Definitely keep it away. The most times we see toxicities are when animals get into a purse or something like that. It's usually not in the, if you keep it in the cabinet, you should be safe, but
what are the
make
symptoms?
Sure you, initially they start off with vomiting sometimes. Sometimes they can seem confused or dizzy, mm-hmm. maybe a little bit wobbly or stumbling. At high enough doses, like I said, you start seeing seizures and other neurologic activity.
So they have to get to the vet right away if you begin to see this
correct.
Stuff. Now the problem is charcoal is a normal thing for poisoning,
correct.
But it doesn't work well in this case.
Exactly. Normally with any toxicity, we go ahead and administer activated charcoal, which helps bind any of the toxin that's sitting in their GI tract. Mm-hmm. In this situation, xylitol is not bound very well with charcoal, and so that first line of defense is missing. So the most helpful would be to get them to the vet and induce vomiting as soon as possible.
Okay. So, and xylitol is not in every gum, and is gum the only thing it's in?
Usually not. Most of our toxicities we see with gum, but it's also coating some pills. It's also, you can buy it in bulk to use as a sugar substitute. But more often than not, we see the toxicity related to gum.
Okay, xylitol is the important thing there to keep in mind.
Right.
All right. So, and this little guy survived twice, but very luckily.
Exactly. He's been doing great, so.
Stay out of that stuff. All right. Now we have some questions on some other subjects that we've gotten in the email here. Megan in Middle River writes, I have an indoor cat with a voracious appetite. He's nearly 10, eats like a goat. But never puts on weight. In fact, he seems a little underweight. Could there be a thyroid problem here?
Oh, yes, absolutely. That's the key thing that you look for with thyroid issues. You need to get him to your vet and get blood work done, get senior blood work. And I recommend senior blood work for any animal above the age of 10, just to check kidney function, liver function, mm-hmm. thyroid issues, things like that. Blood sugar, look for diabetes, all those things. You know, diabetes, kidney disease, thyroid issues will all cause weight loss in an otherwise healthy-seeming pet. So.
Okay. On to dogs now, and this is very appropriate. Dave in Pasadena writes and wants to know, with the temperatures warming up, should we get our golden retriever's coat trimmed shorter, or does that put him at greater risk for sunburn? I guess this might be the case for a lot of dogs.
That's a good question. Most Goldens have pigmented skin, mm-hmm. So I think he should be okay for that. As long as he doesn't have albino or pink skin, I think that he should be okay. I would go ahead and get his coat trimmed, because I know if I were carrying around that much of a shaggy coat in the summertime, I'd want it gone.
So on long-haired dogs, the lightening the coat up a little bit does help them in the summertime.
I think so. I think it definitely does, and you see it in their behavior as well. You see that they're seem a lot healthier and happier when it's a little cooler
but
out.
But the color of the skin underneath is a complicating factor in that.
Correct. If they have pink or unpigmented skin, then that's an increased risk for sunburn. If they have pigmented skin, then they should be okay.
Okay, well, thanks for joining us this morning.
No
a lot
problem.
Of information
Thank
that we had for you.